This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we welcome Bonefish Grill. Chef Adam is here. And you're actually making a dish that when my mother met you just a couple minutes ago, she said she loved it when she ate it at the restaurant. What are we making today?
That is quite the coincidence. But today we're going to be making a Chilean sea bass done Pan Asian style, which I'll be making the Pan Asian sauce from scratch. So your viewers will be happy to follow along with the recipe.
Okay, we like that. So then what are, I'm looking at the counter, kind of minimal ingredients here. I like that. Makes it easy for us. What do we need?
Okay, first step, we have minced garlic. We have minced ginger, and we have canola oil.
Okay.
Then this would be an oyster sauce, ketchup, soy sauce. Now, for your guests out, for your viewers and people who have gluten allergies, if you substitute a gluten-free soy with this, you make this entire dish gluten-free.
Wow.
All right.
That's a great option.
Well, thank you. We have lemon juice, freshly squeezed, sugar, and our final ingredient, chopped cilantro.
So what of these ingredients goes into the sauce, all of them?
All of it. We'll be doing it in stages. What we'll be doing is, this is stage one right here, the garlic, ginger, and oil. We'll cook that for approximately a minute, not allowing it to brown, because that means you overcooked it. Then we'll add stage two, which is these five items right here. We'll bring that to a simmer. Once that comes to a simmer, we'll add the sugar. We have to allow that to dissolve. When you allow it to dissolve, it'll sit for 5 minutes. Then we add the cilantro, shut off the heat, and cool it down, and you are done. Simple process, but delicious sauce.
Look at that. And I like that you've even broken it down in steps for us.
I wanted to make it easy for your viewers.
He's got it. Make it easy on a Friday, headed into Mother's Day. Maybe you can even make it this weekend for mom.
Or come see me, and I'll make it for you.
There you go. We're going to show you how it's done in just a bit.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Adam is here from Bonefish Grill. He is cooking up a storm. We've got Chilean sea bass with Pan Asian sauce that you've made, too. And when I walked in here, all you can smell is this. And the smell, and just looking at it, it looks beautiful.
It is. It absolutely. The aroma, the reduction of the sauce itself will release it to your whole house if you make this at home. And as you stated a moment ago, this is not just something that goes on fish.
Right.
You could put this on chicken. You could put this on steak, pork even.
Yeah.
It really translates well to whatever your protein tastes go towards.
Forever. And it has almost like a sweet, sweet aromatic, you know, smell to
Very
it, too.
Very good. The ginger is what really pops and releases.
And I love ginger. Okay, so what are we going to do right now?
Okay, right now what we're going to do is we finish the sauce.
Sure.
And once the sauce is done, it needs to chill. I have a finished product right here, so we're just going to pop that on.
And how long should this simmer on a stove?
It's 5 minutes.
Okay.
5 minutes to simmer. Once you add the cilantro, chopped cilantro is the last step. I believe we posted it up.
Yep.
But the last step is to add the cilantro, take it off the heat, and immediately refrigerate.
Okay.
Okay. That's what you want to do. You want to bring it down to 40 degrees as quickly as possible.
As possible. Good tip.
All right.
So there you got this over here.
We'll heat this up a little bit. Now over here, we're going to finish off this piece of sea bass that we have right here.
Right.
Excuse me.
Yep. Put that in there. You got the sea bass. And how long does that usually have to sit in the...
We just kept it in there to warm it up.
Okay.
Well, just to keep it warm, because we didn't, timing wise, I wanted to have it ready for you, even though you're not going to eat it.
Right. It's all right. I still love you, Adam.
Thank you. Have me back, please. I'd like to come back.
So this is going to sit on this griddle for about how long?
Total would be 8 to 10 minutes. We're looking for internal temperature 135 to be properly cooked.
All right, good. Perfect. Okay, so that's going to sit. We're going to piece this all together in just a little bit and talk about the great restaurant that Bonefish Grill is and Chef Adam over here. We're going to get to that just a little bit. Back to you. Bonefish Grill is cooking. Oh, they're kicking it.
Wow.
We're
kicking it in the kitchen. Yeah, we like that. Chef Adam's here today, and he's been kicking it and cooking it.
We've been having a blast.
Yes,
we are.
Thank you. We got a nice little sizzle. I love that sound. Happening with this Chilean sea bass here. So tell us what you did to kind of prep that.
What we do to the sea bass, one is the chef or managing partner, we only want to cut fish. So we inspect the fish as it comes in the back door, temping everything, cutting, checking for bones, structure, checking for the right colors, all of that. Now these pieces are cut to 8.5 ounces, all right? Now what I've done is just light oil just to get it that golden color that you want. And now we've already checked the internal temperature of 135, which we've held 15 seconds, so we know the fish is perfectly done and ready to consume.
Okay.
Nice.
All right.
So what happens now?
Well, now we plate it and you eat it.
All right.
Seems easy.
Good.
Seems easy. When I'm involved, nothing's ever that easy, though.
We've got a nice sizzle going there, and you and Will were working on that sauce.
Let's talk about this again, because this can go on anything, not just the sea bass.
Absolutely. Well, thank you. Yeah. We're not going to do that for you. I told you.
I know,
if you invite me back, I'll do something special. Now, this Pan Asian sauce, you see, this is a completed product. Once we refrigerated the product that you saw me making on camera,
right,
this will be heated up, warmed. Mm-hmm. Okay, as you can see, okay, this little steam coming off. Now, we're gonna dress this halfway, mm-hmm, a little tail. Okay, we wanna present it. That would be my friend Maddie. My friend Maddie's the artist. Now, if I may.
Sure.
All right, if you'll grab that bottle right there, that is sashimi sauce. That is for camera.
Okay.
This is a special sash sauce. We're just gonna put three dashes. Dash, dash, dash.
Perfect.
Done with that. Now, Michaela, do you cook it all?
Yeah.
Okay, if you would grab a nice pinch of that garnish. That is a thinly julienned. It's scallions, and we make a little ball with it.
Okay.
And then we place it right on the middle. You can do this. I know you can.
I don't know if I can. It's not really.
You got it. Look, there you go. Let's see.
Okay.
Oh, that's better than yours, Maddie. Better than yours.
Maddie's fired.
Maddie's We love Maddie. So that would be our completed product right there. That
there you
is
go.
What
beautiful.
You would eat.
And again, remind folks at home too, what went into that sauce to make it those, you know, bringing out those Asian flavors.
These Asian flavors are the minced garlic, the ginger, the soy sauce. They're like, I think I mentioned earlier, if you have gluten problems, please don't be afraid to substitute a gluten-free soy sauce, and then you're all set.
One simple swap, and
one
and
simple
then you're
swap,
good.
It's gluten-free.
Beautiful.
Now, a couple of months ago, we had our Search for Star party at Bonefish.
Yes,
it was a great night, but I was that guy who goes to Bonefish, which is known for seafood, mm-hmm, and I'm the guy who asks for a steak, and you prepared a steak. And it was great. It was great. So you do
all
get phone calls saying,
wonderful,
hey, do you have anything other than seafood? You do.
All the time.
Yeah.
All the time. We have wonderful Fontana pork chops, two-size fillets, sirloins, chicken marsala, pasta dishes.
Yum.
You know, we are predominantly, I mean, we made our name on the fish, the fresh fish,
sure,
you know, fresh scratch kitchen sauces. But yes, absolutely. There's no menu mm-hmm rejection.
You get a lot of
place
love for everybody.
And you're featured in this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly.
Yes, well, thank you.
That's a great little feature. We love working with them. And you also have something else that you wanted to mention.
Yeah,
too.
You were gracious enough to let me speak to our Ocean Trust Tropical Heat Martini. What that is, $1 out of every martini that we sell, mm-hmm, is going to go to the Ocean Trust Foundation, which helps to keep the balance of seafood, which Bonefish is very in tune with the product that we sell and the environment. Okay,
make sure you're doing it the right way.
Right. We don't want to fish any species out.
Sure.
We don't want to be that company. And it's a wonderful, we do what's called bar fresh cocktails, which means we infuse our own. It's a pineapple infused vodka that we do in-house.
That is
fresh
good
ingredients.
Good
Look
stuff.
At that. We love that. All right. Don't forget, you can find this recipe at WPRI.com.